Welcome back to the Awaaz UK YouTube channel, where today we're taking a look at the new Aquamax Eco Premium. This is a filter and watercourse pump capable of being installed in your pond or dry sited. There are six models in the range: the 5000, the 7000, the 9000, the 13000 that we're looking at today, the 17000, and the 21000. Included in the box, we have the Aquamax unit itself, fitted with 10 meters of power cable and an assortment of hose tails and attachments to incorporate the pump into your pond with ease. So let's take a look around the outside of the Aquamax Eco Premium. This is a solids pump capable of handling 10 to 11 mil solids. The large surface area of the pump means the water will travel slowly through the holes into the casing. This means it will draw in less debris, meaning less cleaning and less maintenance in the long run. On the top of the casing, we have the larger holes to draw in the majority of the water. And on the side, we have the smaller holes where the pump will sit closer to the bed of the pond. And on the top of the casing, we can see these leaf ridges to ensure that any large pieces of debris do not block the flow of the pump. If you're running your pump submerged at the bottom of your pond, we recommend using the 2-inch hose tail for the most efficient use of your pump and to deliver the most water for the least electricity. In this video, we are using the 1.5-inch hose tail. This is attached to the fitting point on the side of the pump here with this locking nut. Looking to the front of the pump here, currently covered by this blanking plug, is a secondary inlet for the pump. With the inlet capped and in this position, the pump will run as normal. But this inlet can be used for a variety of reasons, including a surface skimmer or a satellite strainer to draw water from two places in your pond at the same time. Using a surface skimmer with a secondary inlet would allow you to draw water from the bottom of the pond using the pump and the top of the pond using the skimmer. To start using this fitting, first remove the blanking cap and attach a hose tail with this locking nut. We recommend trimming these hose tails to the size of your hose, and when fitting your hoses on, ensure that they are as short as possible to reduce any air bubbles. To adjust the flow rate between the two inlet points, at the bottom on the front here, we can see these five numbers ranging from 0 to 4. With this switch in the 0 position, all of the water is going to be drawn in through the casing. Moved over to position 4, everything will be drawn in through the secondary inlet on the front of the pump. Setting this to position 2 will ensure an even flow between the casing and the secondary inlet. And you can move this to whichever position you like based on your pond's requirements. Now let's take a look inside the casing of the Aquamax Eco Premium. To open up, there are no screws, just these 4 blue clips around the outside, the same color blue for every Awaaz product to indicate that they are to be interacted with. So simply pop these off. And we can now remove the lid. And inside, we can now see the main motor unit of the pump. And we can now get an even closer look at how the front inlet works to divide the water flow. One important reminder, if you are using the secondary inlet and you take this out of the pond for cleaning, be sure to return this to the same position you had when you took it out, so you do not experience a change in flow when you switch the pump back on. To remove the main motor unit from the casing, we first remove this rubber lined mounting clip, and we can now remove the main unit from the casing. The secondary manifold that we showed earlier can also be removed for easier cleaning. On the top of the pump here, we can see this blue switch. This is a seasonal flow control switch. Having this in the off position will mean the pump will run at full power all year round. This switch is an energy saving feature for the winter months. In the on position, the pump will regulate its flow dependent on the water temperature. During the winter months, as your water cools, the water does not need as much turnover. This is because there is more oxygen in colder water, algae is growing slower, you're feeding your fish less. There are many reasons for this. And all of this means you do not need as much water flowing through your filter. In the winter, the pump will slow its flow rate, reducing the power draw and saving you energy. And this can be adjusted for your temperature requirements. The pump will also reduce the flow steadily, dependent on the water temperature, so you always have the flow rate you need for the temperature of the water. Activating this switch can save you between 25 and 30% of your running cost over the course of a year. To access the impeller inside the main housing unit, we have these four screws. Simply loosen these and release the housing. And inside we can see the impeller, which is magnetically held in place and can be taken away for easy cleaning. When replacing the impeller back into the motor unit, be sure not to put your fingers on the outside of this plastic ring here, as the powerful magnet will draw the impeller back into place. We can now reintroduce this casing back into the main mount, and the main unit is now reassembled. This section here can be reintroduced at 90 degree intervals if you are dry sighting and need to mount it in a different position. If you wish, these pumps can also be dry sighted. These 2-inch threadings are perfect for your koi setup. To do this, we have this mounting cradle, which comes installed inside the main casing of the Aquamax. Simply unscrew and release this, and you can now use this to attach to a solid surface. The Aquamax will simply slide inside here, as it does in the main casing. And we can also reattach the mounting clip for extra security. The Aquamax Eco Premium is now part of the Awaz control range and is fully integratable with your smart garden control system. This is all controllable through an app, and you can even control the seasonal flow switch using that. On the back of the pump, we can see this blanking plug, which when removed will reveal an Awaz control connection point. You can plug this directly into your established smart garden control system, or you can run other devices off of it using the Awaz control adapter. Simply plug this into the back of your pump, and you now have a new inlet and outlet plug for your other smart garden devices. This adapter can be used whether your pump is dry sighted or installed in your pond. This cable, along with the power cable, will pass through the rubber seal at the back of the casing. To reassemble this unit and introduce it back into the casing, first ensure that this manifold is attached to the front. It's a simple push, and this can now be reintroduced to the casing. Remember to make sure that the secondary inlet manifold is set to your desired position. We can now reattach the mounting clip, and finally place the top of the casing back on and reclip the four blue clips. If you have removed them, reattach your 2-inch hose tails with the screws. If you're not using the secondary inlet, be sure to reintroduce the blanking plug. And that is now ready to be reintroduced back into your pond. And that is our product rundown video on the Aquamax Eco Premium range. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions about this product, be sure to head to our website and let us know down in the comments what products you'd like to see some videos on. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you never miss a video, and see you in the next one.